In politics, man, Alabama lawmaker uses a racist slur, recorded council member face calls to resign. So face calls to resign, facing calls to resign. So, Jamie, can you play the video to that?
Do we have a house nigger in here?
Yeah, we do.
Would she please stand up?
Yeah, I was seeing it right up there.
Man.
Yo, let me say something, right? And I know that we try to refrain from this word, but sometimes it's appropriate. When
go ahead.
The thing is, where's a real nigga when you need one? Because the thing is, somebody should have jumped up and said, "No, ain't no house niggas in here, but there's some real niggas in here," and they should have jumped on his ass.
Yeah, word.
No, we lost Kelvin. But listen, if ever there was a time for one to be in the room, that was it. What's going on, Damien? What's happening, brother?
What's up, baby?
Yeah, man.
Right, you said it best. I know we don't like to use that word here on that child bless child, but now you want to see the real one come up. But that's the time when it should have came out. Now the thing he attacked a black woman right there. Right?
And that's the other thing. He wouldn't have said that to no man, bro.
No, you wouldn't have said to no alpha male like us.
That place should have blew up if it had the right people in there. And I'm not talking about planting a bomb or anything like that.
No.
I'm talking about basically the situation should have been severely addressed.
Yeah.
You know, but hey,
Wait, like my favorite song, Kelvin, Try Jesus.
Yo, let me tell you something. As soon as that came off, my computer shut down just because I knew where I was going.
Kelvin, what's your thoughts on that, man? I forgot his name. His name is John Tommy Bryant.
Definitely put it out there.
John Tommy Bryant.
And let the internet do its job.
Yes. I woke up to that this morning.
Yeah.
I just think at the end of the day, man, for something, and I think it's something that people have been alluding to, the fact that it's so natural, the fact that it's so effortless, it just seems like that they are empowered to just disrespect people like that. And again, I've said this for the longest, I've been touting it. The reality of it is this: certain people know certain communities you don't mess with, and ours is easy prey. It's easy. There's no repercussion. There's no recourse. And not only that, the man doubled down. Talking about he may run for mayor. I'm talking about they even gave him a chance. Would you do anything different? He was like, absolutely not.
Right.
They asked him, are you a racist? The man said, it depends on what your definition of a racist is. So, yeah. I mean, you know, at the end of the day, man, I just think there has to be a way. And I always believe the first thing is to make people feel it financially. That's the first thing.
Yeah,
you know, in the pocket.
And you got to think about that. This is why they don't want to have critical race theory, which should be called critical race facts. The theory is somebody's thought, and
it's facts.
So this is why they want to get rid of it, because they want to just say all this crazy stuff and say there's no racism. They want to just discount everything that comes out of their mouth, like that's what's it called, alternative facts. Even if I said it, oh, that's alternative fact. I didn't say that. We just heard them this time on camera call somebody a house nigga.
They get real bold. It's just real matter of fact. And you know what we're gonna do? You know, we will complain, we're gonna be shocked and appalled, we're gonna share it on Facebook, everybody. No, we're gonna do nothing.
What disturbs me is the fact that the lady was so emotionally distraught that she had to get up and leave. Now she live in Alabama. Okay. I mean, you just gotta return serve. And I'm not saying you gotta get whatever like that, but you don't let somebody run you out like that. You just don't do that. You know what I'm saying?
You gave him power.
Right. Let me tell you something. These words are disturbing to me. They're not crushing to me.
Right.
They're not gonna crush my spirit with it. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, I mean, what we could do is we could have a civil discussion, or we can get out there on that concrete. But them days back in the day where you could just kind of like just, you know, spout off and just disrespect people, those days are over. Nobody's trying to hear that anymore. And I hate the fact that the lady was so hurt by it, you know what I mean, that she had to get up and leave, because you don't let somebody run you out of a place like that. And I know it's tough, but you know, I've heard it, and to me, that's their go-to word. That's the game changer.
They get a rise out of you. They know you get a rise out of you every time you sit there, and we oblige them every time. When we were coming up, there was certain things you just didn't do. You know, you just didn't say certain things or repercussions for just coming up and saying something in somebody's presence that way. you know? Yeah. And, you know, that's no longer there. I don't know if that's off the table now or whatever it is, but, you know.
Yeah, but Kelvin said it best. But the only thing they understand is money loss and blood loss. So you see, yeah. He would have probably had to lose some blood that day. Because I don't care if we're in chambers. I don't care. It's always a proper time to get it on.
That might have been the time. I got to admit, that might have just been the time.
The only thing we have is space, and you already presented me the opportunity, so now let's get it on. Like, that black man, I know he's trying to stay calm, though, sitting there, and he said, you see, we got this on camera. I would have raised up out of my seat.
Yeah.
And I would have smacked fire at him, because once, like Mike said, everybody got a plan until you fucking get punched in the face, right? So that would have been like, okay, you got this, you got to say some words like, bong, punch him in the face. Now I keep saying that shit. Every time they get punched in the face, they would stop saying that shit.
Yeah, every time. You just understand what, you know, what you said. That's why you got punched in the face. It shouldn't be no ambiguity. Everybody understands. That's why you got your snapback, Rob. Yeah. Everybody should know that, you know?
And just plead temporary insanity in court, that's all.
There you go.
Say, I lost control because I was so upset.
Yeah.
articulation, man. You need articulation in certain things, you know?
Oh,
you got to be able to articulate.